Hello, my name is Sascha Selke, and today I'm going to show you a visual approach to understanding harmonic relations in songwriting, or music in general. I was inspired to do this by two things. First, I just recently stumbled over the Coltrane Circle by jazz musician John Coltrane, which is still kind of mysterious, if you like to. But you can use what we'll see today to explain it. And I also stumbled over a really cool video by Friedemann Findeisen of Holistic Songwriting, his YouTube channel. I'm giving you all the links in the description below. And now let's get going with what I call the Mediant Mandala. Let's go. Okay, here we are. Now let's look at what I call the Mediant Mandala, which organizes chord progressions in a way that's a visual way that makes them easier to understand visually. So you can use this for analyzing, as I said, songs and other kinds of music, and you can also use this for your own writing. So let's start out with what I call the twins, the diatonic medians. I'm going through this rather quickly because I assume you have already heard this when you studied music. Okay, so the twins are the diatonic medians. To get the diatonic medians, this here is C major, or root chord, on the root note C, and you add the 2/3 to make a C major. And now if you move down to A and have a try it on A, that's the A minor chord, and that's the parallel minor of C major, and of course if you move up a third, you get to E minor, which is a counter parallel minor. So up and down a third gives you the parallel and counter parallel minors. They're also called the diatonic minors because they are the medians that you get when you use the diatonic scale. They're called medians because the bass note is in the middle between the root chord's bass note and its fifth in the middle. So that's why it's called medians. So that was easy. I think everybody knows this. So next thing, the circle of fifths and fourths. You have heard of this, of course. Circle of fifths and fourths organizes all the key signatures in a circle. You go up by a fifth, G, D, A, and you go down by a fifth in the other direction, F, B flat, and so on, which is, of course, the same as going up a fourth. So if you go to in this direction, clockwise, you get one new sharp with each step. And if you go down, you get one new flat with each step. You can also add the parallel minors, so the diatonic submedians, and the counter parallel minors, that's the higher, the upper median, if you just use the same keys as the root chord connected or associated with the key signature. And here you can see the key signatures, so that's the whole picture. Okay, but you knew this already. Now comes the interesting thing that many, well, or let's say some people, even if they studied some basic music theory, have not yet included in their knowledge, and that's the chromatic medians. So if, I call them cousins because they are still in the family, but they're a bit further related. So if we start again with a C major, and now we go down again and up again, a third, we would get, as you expect, the diatonic medians, but if we insert the accidentals for C minor, so that's B, E flat and A flat, and apply them to those medians, they become chromatic medians. So from C, we're now going to A flat major, of course, and E flat major. So that's a bit of a slight stretch. For you, it may sound a bit unusual, but don't forget, they are still closer, rather closely related. They relate by a third, but it's the chromatic third. That's why they're called the chromatic major medians. They're based on the chromatic thirds to the roots, root chords, root note. Now, you may think that this is rather peculiar to use, but it goes way back. It's not really that modern. Carlo Gesualdo da Venosa used them excessively in his work. So he was a great composer, and he was also a murderer. Look it up, funny story. Another composer who used those chromatic medians was Mozart, but you also find them in the works of Brahms, in the works of Tchaikovsky. You find them excessively in the works of Richard Wagner, especially in his Der Ring des Nibelungen. And if you're looking for more modern music or more popular places where you, I'm sure, have heard chromatic medians a lot, then you can look at film music. John Williams uses them a lot for Star Wars. Basil Poledouris used them for Conan the Barbarian, John Williams again for Harry Potter, and of course Howard Shore and his great soundtrack for The Lord of the Rings. Find them, they're all over the place. So they're really not that new. So let's bring the whole family together and let's repeat. We started out with the twins, the diatonic medians, then we looked at the circle of fifths and fourths that we had combined with the twins, and then we added the cousins. Yeah, at least we looked at the cousins, that's the chromatic medians. And now bring this together. Here we have a circle, and I've put down all the semitones in one octave here. You start at C, C sharp, D, D sharp, and go up the line from, until you finally come from B to C again. That's one full octave, separated into its equal semitones, and those are equal because, of course, we're talking about modern equal tuning here. So then I added the twins, parallel and counterparallel minor. So each group here, that's the twins, and they are organized in half-tone steps up and down. So now we're going to add the key signatures, and we shall also add the triads themselves. So you can see here's the C major with its twins, and they walk up in semitones to the next octave. So now let's put in the siblings into the picture. We're adding the circle of fifths and fourths. I'm beginning by putting in a connection line from our root chord C major to G, that's the fifth up, and to F, that's the fifth down, or fourth up, which is the same. So those orange lines connect each single chord to its siblings in the circle of fifths and fourths. And of course we do this for every single one. And here we get the full picture. This 12-sided star connects all chords, each single chord, to its siblings in the circle of fifths and fourths. And now comes the magic. Here's the upper chromatic medians. We started with those. So to bring them into the picture, we're adding the upper chromatic median to C major, and that would be, you can see C major, that would be E flat. It goes up 1, 2, 3 half-tone steps. And we do this, of course, again for all the half-tone steps. So since it's three steps and we have 12 steps in an octave, so if you divide 12 by the three steps we're taking, 12 divided by 3 would be 4, and so what you get is geometric forms that have four sides that are the same length, and that's a square. Okay, now let's put in the chromatic medians. Same chromatic median from C, the chromatic submedian to C as to C major, as we've seen, would be A flat major. And again, we put those in for each of the single half tone steps in the octave. And since this is this connection goes by four half tone steps. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 12 divided by 4 is, that equals 3. So you get a geometric shape that has three sides that are the same, which is a triangle. Okay, and now we're going to do it for real. Now we're going to put everything in it. So we start out with all our chords. The twins are already there. We put in the circle of fifth and fourth, that's the siblings. We put in the chromatic upper medians, the chromatic lower medians, and now we combine this circle fifth and fourth plus the chromatic upper medians plus the chromatic lower medians or submedians, and you have the full mediant mandala. That's it. That's the beauty of it. Look at it. Great. Okay. Now this is a new way to, maybe not so new, but maybe it's new that you can visualize this in this way. Each of these lines shows a connection to a chord. Some connections are extremely close. They don't even need lines because they're twins. Some, the orange lines, are the circle of fifth and fourth, and the dark reddish lines are the connections over the cousins, the chromatic medians. So, as I said in the beginning, this can help you understand music better and better understand relationships in harmony. But it would be nice if we could make use of it, wouldn't it? Now we see how we can use this to better understand chord relations and harmonic relations in music. And as an example, I've selected three songs by Radiohead, one of the greatest rock bands ever. The first one would be No Surprises. So let's listen at the chord changes. So it's F to B flat minor. Okay, let's try to understand this if we only have the circle of fifth and fourth and the twins, of course, the parallel minors and counter parallel minors. So if we start with F, how do we get from F to B flat minor? We need to go two steps in between. First, B flat major, E flat major, A flat major, and now finally we come to D flat major with its twin, B flat minor. So it's four steps we need to get there. But let's look at the same if we have the median mandala. How many steps do you need to get from F major to B flat minor? Kaboom! One. That's it. One step, not more. Because D flat major is already the chromatic submediant to F. And here it's twin. Okay. So instead of having to take four steps along the circle of fifth and fourth to work your way up to the necessary accidentals, you can take just one step using the chromatic medians. Not bad. Okay, let's look at another song, Karma Police. Okay, so that's C major, D major, G major, and F sharp major. You may already have a hunch that this guy here, the F sharp major, might make problems. Okay, how do we get from C to D major? Using just the circle of fifth, you need to go, of course, over a step in between the G, up to G, and then up to D. And that's two steps, and to G obviously one step back. But now how do you get from G major to F sharp major? Using the circle of fifth, you'd need to go, because F sharp has, as you can see, six sharps, you need to go up all the steps. I made it shorter. You need to go up from G, which already has one sharp, and for each sharp you need to do one step in the circle of fifth, so you need five steps to go up to F sharp major. Now let's look at it again, but this time we apply the median mandala. From C to D, it's still the same, two steps, back to G, the same, one step. But how do I get from G major to F sharp major? It takes me just two steps using the median mandala, because to G, E flat is the chromatic submediant. And the chromatic upper mediant to E flat would be G flat major, which is the same as F sharp, of course. So instead of having to go 2 + 1 + 5, that's 8 steps, we just need 5 steps. Not so bad, not so bad. Much easier. And, well, it stays in the family. You can see the relation is there. It's a bit of a stretched relation. That's why you don't see your cousins as often as you see your siblings, probably. And you see your twins more often than your other siblings, maybe. Who cares? Okay, let's get on. The last song I'm going to try to use this on is Creep. So let's look at it or listen to it.
just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You float like a feather.
So that's G major, B major, C major, and C minor. Now let's try the whole thing again. How would we do this? How would we connect this if we only have the circular fifth and fourth and the twins? That's the parallel minors to the major chords. We start with G major, and how do we get from G major to B major? G has one sharp, and B major has five sharps, so it should be four steps. To D, up to A, up to E major, and then up to B major, four steps in the circular fifth. So how do we get back to C? Of course, we have to go all the way back the four steps to G, and then from G, we can walk down a fifth to C. So that's four steps and plus five steps. And how do we get from C major to C minor? C minor, of course, it's a twin of E flat major, as it has three flats, so we need to walk down three steps over the circle of fourths. So that's how these chords connect, using just the circle of fifths and fourths. So that's all in all 12 steps. Okay, let's look at the same thing when we have our chromatic medians in place and use the median mandala. So from G major to B major, it's just kaboom, one step, one single step. Why? Because to B major, G major is the chromatic submediant. How do we get from B major to C over the circle of fifth? Easy. And from C major to C minor is also just one step. Why? Because to C, E flat major is its chromatic upper median, and its twin is C minor. So instead of having to take 12 steps over the circle of fifth and fourth, you just need a meager four steps to reach the last chord if you use the chromatic medians filled into our median mandala. So I hope this makes it clear that the understanding of chromatic medians and the median mandala shows you that those chords in Radiohead's music that seem so weird and eerie, maybe, but still work for some reason, they do work because they are related. They seem a bit weird sometimes because it's not a relation as close as between the twins or the siblings, it's the cousins, but the relation is there, and in the end it all stays in the family. So that was quite a bit. I hope you liked it. I hope it helped you in understanding Radiohead better and understanding music better, maybe even give you an inspiration for your own songwriting. That would be really cool. If you want to get deeper into the topic of chromatic medians, go to, for instance, a really cool video by Rick Beato. I'm giving the links in the description. And yes, I hope the inspiration goes on to you. Bye-bye.